If you remember, in one of the problems we said rate of a reaction can be measured using a titration. If you remember that the hydrolysis of ester, so you have an ester and you can measure the rate of reaction by titrating the produced acetic acid with any base, you can have any OH. In that case you have to have H plus initial, you have to also account for that. So initial volume is proportional to initial H plus, that is the concentration of catalyst. After that time, the volume of NaOH will be proportional to acetic acid produced plus initial H plus. Now the same kind of problem we have. So decomposition of H2O2, so everybody knows H2O2 decomposes and it gives you H2O liquid plus half O2. So this time we can again measure the progress of this reaction using titration. So you see H2O2 basically acts as a reducing agent if I react with KMnO4. So H2O2 acts as a reducing agent. You're getting? So if I titrate this with KMnO4, reducing agent with KMnO4, reducing agent against KMnO4, you can say. So if I titrate this with KMnO4, I will simply have a acid oxidation reduction titration. You see, in the previous problem we have a reduction acid based titration. This time we have oxidation reduction titration. Are you getting? So you see, if I the initial KMnO4, so what I will do is, I will take some volume of KMnO4, H2O2, I will take some volume of H2O2 at different time interval, and this I will titrate with KMnO4. So by knowing the volume of KMnO4, I can say the volume of KMnO4 is directly proportional to a volume of H2O2, or you can say normality or molarity, you can find out, is directly related to concentration of H2O2. So I can say, I can write one equation something like this: H2O2 dissociate, and this gives H2O plus half O2. Are you getting or not? So this is initially, this is A, this is 0, this is 0. So this is at T is equals to 0. After time T, so let us say T is equals to T, I can see this is A minus X, this is X, this is X. So let us say initial time, the volume of KMnO4 used is V0. So I can say V0 is proportional to A, initial time. So initially we have volume of KMnO4 used is V0. So this is initially at T is equals to 0, volume of KMnO4 is used is V0. So this will be proportional to A. After some time T, volume of KMnO4 used is, let us say VT. So this will be proportional to mole of H2O2, because some of the H2O2 has already oxidized. So this is proportional to A minus X. So basically V0 is what? Volume of KMnO4 at T is equals to 0. VT is what? Volume of KMnO4 at T is equals to T. Are you getting or not? So this is the volume. So now I can say if I divide these two, so I will have, so this is equation 1, let us call this equation 2. If I divide, we will have V0 by VT is equals to A by A minus X. Now we know everything, because rate of a reaction K is given by 2.303 by T log A by A minus X. So log A by A minus X is nothing but V0 by VT. So by calculating the volume initially and at any one more time, I can calculate VT, and I know the time, I can calculate the rate constant. If I perform three times reaction, I will one time will get K, again I will get K, again I will get K. So if I'm doing the reaction three times, I'm getting three times K. Now if they follow the first order kinetics, in that case the three K's should be equal. So this is a proof for first order kinetics. So somebody says the decomposition of H2O2 is a first order kinetics proof. So how will you do that? So you will do this expression, you will take this expression, you plug the value of Vt and T, you find the K, you again do the experiment, find VTT, find out K. Again do the experiment third time, you find K. If you see the three times, K are approximately equal, that is very little change, let us say 0.1 or 0.2, then in that case you can say this is a first order kinetics, because the error is coming due to the some measurement error, so that is the error due to experimental error. So in that case, what the K you will report? So you will report the average K. So first time you will getting K1, second time you are getting K2. So you have to report the average K, K1 plus K2 by 2. If you have 3 experiment, K1 plus K2 plus K3 by 3. So report average K. Are you getting? So if you are doing the experiment 3 times, you have to report basically average K. So that is a important point. So what we have learned in this question is, we have learned something about how to measure the progress of a reaction. So measuring the progress of reaction, it can be done using the titration, it can be done using acid based titration, it can be done using redox titration. So in one case, hydrolysis of ester, we have discussed something acid based titration. Here we have decomposition of H2O2, and here we are using, that is, redox titration, because H2O2 acts as a reducing agent with KMnO4. Are you getting? Can you write the reaction for H2O2 with KMnO4? This is your homework. You have to see H2O2 and KMnO4, what will be the product. So you can see in acidic medium, you can write down the product. So let me leave for you. So you have to report the average K in this case. Are you getting? If somebody has missed something, so let us copy this one. So quite easy problem. Decomposition of H2O2. Another way to measure the reaction rate of decomposition H2O2 is to measure the volume of O2. You see, if you measure the volume of O2, because all the substances are liquid. So this is liquid. This is liquid. This is gas. So you can measure the volume of O2 also. Initially t equals to 0, there is no volume. T equals to T, volume will be some volume will be there. So let us say this, basically this should be x by 2. So this is not volume. So I am writing in terms of, so this is A minus X. So 1 mole dissociate, 1 mole form. So this should be X by 2. Although I am not used this one. X by 2 is not used. So this should be X by 2. So 1 mole decomposes and this gives half mole of O2. Now see, I can basically measure the rate of reaction by measuring the volume of O2 evolved. You're getting? So if the volume of O2 at t equals to 0 is 0, t equals to t x by 2, are you getting or not? So this is mole, I have to convert mole into volume. So I can measure the rate of reaction by measuring the volume of O2 also. So the same reaction can be measured by measuring the volume. T is equals to 0, let us say volume is V0, t is equals to t Vt, and infinite time. So I can, how can I write the reaction? So let us say I will give you one hint here itself. So if I want to measure this reaction S2O2, this decomposes, this give H2O plus half O2, and this is liquid, this is liquid, this is gas, this is A 0 0, this is a T is equals to 0 situation, is something like this. T is equals to T situation is A minus X by 2, and I want to measure the rate of reaction measuring the volume of O2. So I can say, so let us say T is equals to 0, volume of O2 is how much? This is 0. T is equals to T, I have measured volume of VO2 is VT. You're getting? T is equals to, so this is T is equals to T. Now T is equals to infinite, that is for a long time. Basically infinite time does not have meaning in physical sense. This is a meaning, I can say, after a long time when the gas solution has becomes constant, it does not, no gas is evolved now, so that time is T equals to infinite. So VO2 is equals to V infinite. So I can say VO2, that is X by 2 at time T, this is X by 2. So X by 2 is proportional to VT. Are you getting or not? If the time becomes infinite, so I can say at infinite time what will happen. So let me write here itself, T equals to infinite, this will be 0, this will be A, and this will be A by 2. Are you getting? So at infinite time I can say A by 2 is proportional to V infinity. Are you getting? Now if I divide these two equation, I need a by a minus x. So let us divide those two equation x by a. So this is 1, this is 2. If I divide, I can write x by a is bt by b infinity. Are you getting? So if I subtract, I need a by a minus x. A minus x. So what I can do is, let us make this side, let us subtract minus 1 this side, and this side subtract minus 1, both sides. So I will have x minus a by a, this is equals to vt minus v infinity by v infinity. Now I can make a minus x by a is equals to, put the minus on this side also, v infinity minus vt by v infinity. So now from here I have a by a minus x is what? So I have, so let me write here, so a by a minus x is nothing but a by a minus x, that is v infinity by v infinity minus b t. Are you getting? Now I can plug the value of here. Rate constant k is 2.303 by k log a by a minus x is nothing but v infinity minus v t. Are you getting or not? So one can measure the rate of this reaction also by measuring the volume of H2O2 evolved. Are you getting or not? So there are two ways to measure the decomposition of H2O2. One way is to measure the volume of gas O2 evolved. That is simple. Measuring the volume is an easy task. If you do the reaction in a closed vessel, the temperature is constant, you know the R, then you can find out the volume easily. Are you getting or not? So you can measure the volume of O2 evolved if you are doing a reaction in a constant vessel. Pressure is constant, so you can measure the volume. Are you getting or not? So volume measurement, that is a part of experiment we can do always. Now another way to do reduction titration, oxidation reduction titration. H2O2 is acting as a reducing agent with KMnO4. So what I am doing is, initially I am taking a sample of H2O2, I am titrating with KMnO4. This gives V0 volume of KMnO4 used. I do the titration again at T times. Now that time we have VT time, so you see, and now if I subtract, so you see here, you see T is equals to 0, I am using this V0, at T equals to T this VT. Now expression is V0 by VT, so here I have the final expression. K is, if you compare these two, if you measure, this is for KMnO4 titration, and if you this expression for, so this is the second expression which we have derived, so this is from page number 2. So this expression is for volume of O2. Volume O2. Are you getting? So what is the difference? You see, in this expression you have a V0. In this expression you does not have any V0, you have V infinity. And that is important, because in this case oxygen gas evolved at T equals to 0 is 0. And T equals to infinite something constant. And that's why we are getting a V infinite. In final expression I have a V infinite. Are you getting or not? But here if we have, because T equals to 0, you can measure the volume of H2O2. So that's why you have a V0. So initial concentration of H2O is proportional to V0. So in this case you are having V0. In this expression you have V infinity. That is important point. We'll go for the next problem. I think this is the, you have written this one. Okay, let us go for the next problem.